Hello everyone, I welcome you all to my channel. In this video, we are going to see intrinsic and extrinsic semiconductors from the subject electronic devices and circuits. In my previous video, we have seen what is meant by a semiconductor. So in this video, we are going to see what is meant by intrinsic and extrinsic semiconductor. These two are the important classifications of semiconductor. So intrinsic semiconductor means pure form of semiconductor. That means no impurity is added to it. So it is called as intrinsic semiconductor. Now when an electric field is applied across this intrinsic semiconductor, there will be current conduction. So it is due to free electrons as well as holes. So the total current inside the semiconductor is the sum of the currents due to free electrons and holes. Normally at room temperature, intrinsic semiconductor has little current conduction capability. So this is the important property of intrinsic semiconductor. So in general, you have to remember intrinsic semiconductor means it is a pure form of semiconductor, as well as at room temperature there will be less current conduction. So next one is extrinsic semiconductor. So extrinsic semiconductor means it is impure form of semiconductor. That means in the intrinsic semiconductor, if we add impurity to it, it becomes an extrinsic semiconductor. So in order to improve the conductivity property of the intrinsic semiconductor, we go for extrinsic semiconductor. That means we will be adding impurity to it. So this addition of impurity is called as doping. So doping is the process of adding impurity to the pure form of semiconductor. So why we are adding this impurity means in order to increase the conductivity. So increase the conductivity means either we are going to increase the number of free electrons or the holes. So next we are going to see what are the types of impurities can be added. So impurity is nothing but a material. We are going to add a material to a semiconductor. Okay, so here two types of impurities can be added. One is pentavalent impurity and another one is trivalent impurity. From the name itself you can understand pentavalent. Penta means 5. So an impurity or element having 5 valence electrons can be added to the semiconductor. Otherwise trivalent impurity. So trivalent impurity means an element having 3 valence electrons. So already we have seen in a semiconductor we are having only 4 valence electrons. So we can increase the conductivity of a semiconductor by adding pentavalent element or trivalent element. So these are the two types of impurities we can add. So depending upon the type of impurity added, the extrinsic semiconductors can be classified into two. One is n-type semiconductor and another one is p-type semiconductor. So first let us see what is n-type semiconductor. So in a pure form of semiconductor, if we are adding pentavalent impurity means then it becomes as n-type semiconductor. So pentavalent means the element which are having 5 valence electrons, right? So here we are taking germanium as a semiconductor. So germanium atom, with that we are adding an arsenic element. So arsenic is nothing but pentavalent element. So it has 5 valence electrons. So here for this arsenic, 4 valence electrons are bonded with the germanium, but we are having extra one free electron. So this free electron is responsible for conduction. So to improve the conductivity of an intrinsic semiconductor, we are adding a pentavalent impurity. So it becomes as an n-type semiconductor. Okay. Now, the impurities which produce n-type semiconductor are called as donor impurities, because they donate. Okay, they donate their free electrons for conduction. So it is called as donor impurity. So these are the things you have to keep in mind. So n-type semiconductor means we are adding pentavalent impurity to it. Also, this type of impurities are called as donor impurities. Next, p-type semiconductor. So p-type semiconductor means in a pure form of semiconductor, we are adding trivalent impurity. So trivalent means an element which has three valence electrons. So here we are taking an example as gallium. So it has only three valence electron. Here we are having hole. Now this hole is responsible for conduction. So here the majority carrier is hole. So that only we are saying it is p-type semiconductor. Always remember, n-type means it represents electron. Then p-type means it represents holes. Okay. So here holes is the majority carrier. Gallium having only three valence electron. That three valence electrons are bonded with the germanium semiconductor. So here we are having extra hole. Now, the meaning of hole is there is a vacant. So, it will accept an electron. Therefore, this type of impurity is called as acceptor impurities. So, for p-type semiconductor, we will be adding acceptor impurities. And for n-type semiconductor, we will be adding donor impurities. Next, let us see what is majority and minority carriers. So, in n-type material, already we have seen large number of free electrons and it has only small number of holes. That means the large number of free electrons are called as the majority carriers and small number of holes are called as minority carriers. So, it is the case for n-type. But in p-type semiconductor, there will be more number of holes but less number of electrons. Therefore, this more number of holes, it is called as the majority carrier for p-type and these electrons are called as the minority carriers. Now, let us discuss some important multiple choice questions. First question, a semiconductor is formed by dash bonds. Option 1, covalent. Option 2, electrovalent. Option 3, coordinate, and option 4, none of the above. So, semiconductor is formed by covalent bonds. Therefore, option 1 is the right answer. Next question. A semiconductor has dash temperature coefficients of resistance. So, this is one of the important property of semiconductor. It has negative temperature coefficient of resistance because as the temperature gets increased, the conductivity gets increased so that the resistance gets decreased. So, then only we are saying it is negative temperature coefficient of resistance. So, option 3 is the right answer. Next question. The most commonly used semiconductor is option 1 germanium, option 2 silicon, option 3 carbon, option 4 sulfur. So, the most commonly used semiconductor is silicon, option 2. Next question. A semiconductor has generally dash valence electrons. So, already we have seen this. Semiconductor has 4 valence electrons. Therefore, option 4 is the right answer. Next question, the resistivity of pure germanium under standard condition is about. So, the resistivity for pure germanium is 60 ohm centimeter. So, this is the correct answer, 60 ohm centimeter. Next question, the resistivity of pure silicon is about. So, 4 options are given. Option 1, 100 ohm centimeter. Option 2, 6000 ohm centimeter. And option 3, 3 into 10 power 5 ohm centimeter. Option 4, 1.6 into 10 power minus 8 ohm centimeter. The correct answer is that is resistivity of pure silicon is about 6000 ohm centimeter. So, option 2 is the right answer. Next question. When a pure semiconductor is heated, its resistance. So, when the temperature gets increased, the resistance gets decreased because the current conduction gets increased. Therefore, the resistance goes down. So, option 2 is the right answer. Next question. The strength of a semiconductor crystal comes from option 1, forces between nuclei. Option 2, forces between protons. Option 3, electron pair bonds. Option 4, none of the above. So the strength of the semiconductor crystal comes from electron pair bonds. Therefore, option 3 is the right answer. Next question. When a pentavalent impurity is added to a pure semiconductor, it becomes, so penta means 5 valent impurity. So 5 valent impurity if he add means, then that semiconductor becomes an N-type semiconductor. Therefore, option 4 is the right answer. Next question. Addition of pentavalent impurity to a semiconductor creates free electrons, holes, valence electrons, bound electrons. So, pentavalent means 5 valence electron. Already in our semiconductor, we are having 4 valence electron. So, that becomes excess of electrons. Therefore, option 1 is the right answer, that is free electrons. Next question. A pentavalent impurity has dash valence electrons. So, from the name itself, we can understand pentavalent. So, it has 5 valence electrons. Therefore, option 2 is the right answer. An N-type semiconductor is positively charged, negatively charged, electrically neutral, none of the above. So, it has positive charge as well as negative charge. So, it is electrically neutral. So, option 3 is the right answer. Next question. A trivalent impurity has dash valence electrons. So, trivalent, that means it has 3 valence electrons. So, option 4 is the right answer. Next question. Addition of trivalent impurity to a semiconductor creates many. So, trivalent impurity, that means 3 valence. Already our semiconductor have 4 valence electrons. So, that is a vacant position or holes. Therefore, option 1 is the right answer. Next question. A hole in a semiconductor is defined as a free electron, the incomplete part of an electron pair bond, a free proton, a free neutron. So, hole in a semiconductor is defined as the incomplete part of an electron pair bond. That is the vacant position created by an electron. So, that part is called as hole. Therefore, option 2 is the right answer. So, next question. The impurity level in an extrinsic semiconductor is about dash of pure semiconductor. So, it is of 1 atom of 10 power 8 atoms. So, this is the impurity level in extrinsic semiconductor. So, option 2 is the right answer. Next question. As the doping to a pure semiconductor increases, the bulk resistance of the semiconductor, option 1 remains the same, option 2 increases, option 3 decreases, option 4 none of the above. So, if you are adding an impurity to the semiconductor, then its conductivity increases. So, conductivity increases means then its resistance gets decreased. So, option 3 is the right answer. Next question. A hole and electron in close proximity would tend to, option 1, repel each other, option 2, attract each other, option 3 have no effect on each other, option 4 none of the above. So, hole and electron. Electron is negative charge, hole is positive charge. So, it will attract each other. Therefore, option 2 is the right answer. Next question. In a semiconductor, the current conduction is due to holes and free electrons. So, option 3 is the right answer. Next question. The random motion of holes and free electrons due to thermal agitation is called as diffusion. Option 1 is the right answer. I hope you all have understood the concepts we have discussed as well as the multiple choice questions we have discussed. If you like this video, kindly subscribe my channel and share with your friends. Thank you.